So as you saw in the last video, bought a van. Since then, I've done a few bits to it. So I had to take passenger seat out to get to a fuse that powers the cigarette lighter and the USBs in the back for charging your phones and whatnot when on the road, so that was essential. Then I had a bit of a faff of the roof rack because I wanted the tent box on.
And the thing is, we're having a bit of an issue because it's actually wider than what tent box recommend. So there's like, you know, the gap between is like 15 centimetres wider than what they recommend. And I'll tell you for why. There's a rounded Allen key bolt in the fitting that I actually would like to preferably put the roof bar on.
And then once that was done, I was straight to Wales for my first trip in the van, which was mega. If you haven't watched that video, link down below. Little shameless plug as always. But we're back now, and I've got a little bit of a project idea for the van, so we're gonna get cracking on with that right now. I've been back and forth from here to Georgia, Carolina to California, across the hills of middle Tennessee. Welcome back to another video, and if you can't tell, camper bed for the van is well underway, using pallets only because stingy as anything. But yeah, that ain't as fun breaking up that as I imagined it was going to be.
That, my friend, is much easier.
Right, I think that's all the planks I'm gonna need. They've all been denailed. I've kept them in a container just so if I fancy a little bit of an aesthetic rustic look on the outside of the frame where a nail actually isn't needed for structural reasons, bang it in, do you know what I mean? Get a dark stain on is what I'm thinking, dark stain sort of varnish. But next job is sanding these bad boys. And worst case scenario, I need some more wood. I have got another two pallets at the side of the house just in case. Well, now I'm just going to get some measurements for the build so I can start writing out some plans.
So Miz and Oliver, wisdom said, let's get it accurate, use some tape for the frame and get accurate measurements, because maths is not my forte, I'll say that much. Is that bang on the line? Yeah. So the blue tape marks the base, it's going to be a bit wider with the planks coming over the wheel arch. And then I found this little beautiful piece just chilling by a bin, so I helped myself, right, wait for it.
Oh, no.
Do you know what I mean? Because I need extra length because I'm... Oh, cheers, mate. Ow. I need extra length where Miz and Noah, hobbits as you can see, they're all right behind the chairs. But what I didn't anticipate is, because I thought this was spot on, I couldn't believe it. I thought it was a match made in heaven, thinking no cutting is needed, but it is, because say it's about there where the bed height is going to be. It's going to be on a hinge, as you can see. It's not that height, is it? The bed is not that height, so it's gonna have to be cut a little bit, but you get the gist. It's gonna be on a hinge, we're gonna have a bolt so it's not flapping about when I'm driving, but then when I need it, extra length. And we all like a bit of extra length, don't we, lads? That sounded a bit, I meant we'd like a bit of extra length, not we want, you know what I mean.
So I need the bed to clear the wheel arches, so that's 32 centimeters up, which gives me about 95 centimeters of clearance from the roof. So let me see if I can sit comfortably in the bed. All right, so there's 95. Quite happily, mate. That is ideal, isn't it? We're getting to a slightly more exciting part of the build now, where majority of the planks are sanded down and we're gonna lay it out and actually start putting a little bit of a structure together. So as you expect with things like this, there's issues you run into. So I was thinking we would have some planks long enough for the length of it. Don't know why I thought that. I mean, look. Not even near, is it? But we have a solution. Here's one I made earlier. As you can see, two planks with a join. And then what I'm going to do is just put, obviously there's two legs either side, and there's one central, just to give it that little bit of extra support. Job's a good one. And that's today's work, because I'm about to go to work itself, but as you can see, that's the base, these are the legs, and then tomorrow what we'll do is bang that on there. So that's one of two made, which we'll then bolt together, making like a double bed with a flap, like I said earlier, on one side for myself. Anyway, I'm off to work. Another day, another box. We're happy with that, aren't we? Right, let's get some slats on them. But first, we've got to get these in the van to measure up, make sure they actually fit. This will be a laugh, won't it? What the fuck? Well, that definitely doesn't seem right, does it? What was I saying yesterday about when you do this sort of thing, there's always issues? I said my maths was bad, but what's occurred? Oh, I know what I've done. Right, we've got two options. We can either have a slide-out bed, sort of half the size of that box, pulling out there with a flap, like I said earlier, 4 meter laid on that side. Still having the slats coming across here, so you're not losing that wheel arch space for the bed itself. Or I can pull this out, restructure it so it comes around the arch, and have that fitting flush into the corners here, if that makes sense. I think just saying it out loud has made me realise which one I want to go for. Right, some time's passed. To be honest, I knocked that up pretty quick. I'm quite happy with that, but this is the moment of truth, part two. Ready? Oh, that feels as good to you as it did to me. So as you can see, there's a lot of space here because of the wheel arch. So slats will come over a little bit. Obviously, there won't be a mad amount of weight, so there's no worry of any weakness there. Yeah, let's get that done. And we're done. So tomorrow it's just a matter of the flap, but for now, I'm off back to work. We're back on with it after a few days off. Nipped to the Lake District for a trip video, shameless plug. So the job at hand now is just finalising a little bit of sanding on the edges, and then we'll get it in the van and get the flap on. Right, so last time we put this in, didn't have the slats in, if you remember. So let's not have a reenactment of last time where it didn't fit, please. Right, so far so good. That's the easy part. I'm actually nervous. Well, first I'm gonna have to take that net off, aren't I? Right, now net's off the wall and out the way. I've got a bad feeling, lads. I know I should be optimistic. Yeah, I've got an issue. Ah, fucking tow bar's done me in. Oh my god. Oh, hang on. Oh, she's in. She just needed a bit of TLC. That's all she wanted. What I might do is just cut that little bit of plank there, just so it fits in a bit nicer, so it's not touching the wall. Right, let's do the weight bear test then. Oh, she's sturdy. Look at that. All that fun I won't be having, it can take it. Ugh. No, can you see the problem here? And this is where that flap comes in, as I was saying before. So let's get this fitted here. But before we do that, I'm just going to get these nets rearranged. They're really good. They're just like Velcro. And they're brilliant. I love them. Don't take much to keep me happy nowadays. Bit of Velcro with a net in between. Very good. And also, if you go to this side of the van, you'll see I've got a table on the wall, which goes in between the swivel chairs at the front and then the passenger rear seats. And there's already a sticker on there from the last guy that had it. Well, a few. And I just thought, you know what, that's a good idea. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get stickers every time the van takes us somewhere, such as Snowdon. Then I'm just going to get a sticker and bob it on there. And it's just sort of a bit of a memory board, I guess. This is the biggest decision of not only this video, but possibly my life. Whereabouts do we bob it? I think near this one. He's gone for it. He's made the decision. There's no going back now. Ta-da! It's pretty smart, that. If you're asking why I got a second sticker, don't have a clue. I think I did a shill, aka my nan. You order one, you've actually ordered two, maybe three. I don't care for walking downtown. Crazy on a car, gonna run me down. Look at all the people like cows in a herd. Well, I like birds. I think I've lost the plot at this point, lads. I've just been faffing about with this, haven't I? So this is like the leg that stands in. I bought a hinge, lads. I bought a hinge so it can stay on and... Do you know what I mean? Well, I'll never see that again. I mean, the fact that that's the same width, isn't that the most coincidental satisfaction you've ever seen? We'll have a bit of that. So now we bang on some more hinges, but this time, which will attach to the bed. Beautiful. Question is, have we got the length we need for this average-sized man?
Oh, we're happy with that, aren't we?
We both know what's next, don't we? We need a mattress. Now, I've been to a shop that I thought would have it, like just like foam that I could like cut, because obviously it's an awkward shape. Now, they're either thick enough but not long enough, or long enough but not thick enough. So, I've had an idea.
And that is to use the sofa cushions as a mattress.
It's lovely, that. Look, that's perfect.
That is a cosy vibe, is it not?
So Miz just came up with a really sick idea, like a little addition. So as you can see, this is where we're going to put all the storage under here when we go away. But it looks a bit messy, so why not cover it, but not just cover it, have it as a two-purpose thing. So it covers, but it also kicks up, has a leg similar to the flap that gives me leg room. And therefore, you have a little bit of kitchen working space or whatever, just a table in general, when you're out here in the summer. Do you know what I mean?
Well, I'm absolutely buzzing because not only is this going to be a good sleeping area, as you saw last night, we had fish and chips down here and it was just a chill area as well. So two birds, one stone sort of thing, isn't it? So when I got the idea in my head about having a bed in the van, I sort of had a little look online. My friend sent me a link of the bed he has in his transporter, which was about 350, 400 quid. So I was thinking, well, I've just thrown a lot of money at the van. So if I can get away with not spending more money, I will. And I thought, hang on a minute, I could probably make one of these. And do you know what? I'm so glad I did, because I've had so much fun and there's a proper sense of satisfaction doing it. And hand on heart, I probably threw about 25 quid at this, because I was lucky enough where my granddad had all the power tools I needed. I obviously got the pallet wood for free, as you saw, picked it up from the side of the road and whatnot. So all I actually had to do was buy some reciprocating saw blades and a box of screws, and then I was good to go. Now, the only other thing that I would potentially do to it, other than the flap table thing that Miz mentioned earlier on, is stain the wood. Now, at the very beginning of the video, I did mention I wanted a dark stain. As time's gone on, I've changed my mind with that, I think. I'm not quite sure. So for now, I've just left it because I kind of like the look of just the pallet wood. It's kind of like rustic or whatever they say. But you let me know what you think down below. And I reckon we should go our separate ways now, because I've kept you long enough. And if you actually have watched up until now and you watch any of my videos, just thank you. Like, I really appreciate that. Like, I'm having so much fun making these videos. So if you can get any enjoyment from watching them, once again, two birds, one stone. That is class. I will leave you in peace. See you in the next one.